recall a very important law, and that's a law of reflection. You have already seen in previous two videos that if a light ray incidents on a plane mirror, this is a plane mirror, if a light ray incidents on a plane mirror, then it reflects in such a way that the angle of incidence, this is angle of incidence, let me call it as angle I, is always equal to angle of reflection. So this is what we should keep always in the mind. And this is not only for a plane mirror, in everywhere, wherever there is a reflection takes place, this law is followed, right? So having understood the law of reflection, we'll go ahead now. What you're watching in front of you is a preparation for a demonstration of an experiment which I am going to tell you now. I have got a source of light here, and this is a convex lens which I am going to insert inside. So what happens is it will bring all the light rays together, right? Now you can see here light is scattered. So when I keep this here in this way, I get a thick beam of light. I still want a beam of light to be narrow, because this is what we require for our demonstration. And here we get, I'm keeping it a bit straight here so that it is in your view properly. I hope you are watching this properly now. Now this will give you a glare, that's why I'm going to cover this here. Well, I can even take three light rays using another slit. Here it is, and I get three of the light rays here. By moving this lens, I can rearrange the lines so that they are moving parallel to each other. Look at this. So I want light rays which are parallel. When the light fall on a plane mirror, as you have seen in the previous experiment, they reflect. You can watch this reflection now. I am bringing it so close. All these are incident rays. They are parallel to each other. They fall on this plane mirror and they reflect. And look at the reflected rays. They also move parallel. And this kind of reflection is called regular reflection. Because you see here, if this is the incident ray, for this incident ray, this is the reflected ray. For this incident ray, this is the reflected ray. And for this incident ray, this is the reflected ray. So light always follows a rule. Angle of incidence has to be equal to angle of reflection. And that is why when they come parallel, they'll move parallel. Keep this in the mind. As you turn this slightly, the angle between them becomes smaller and smaller, and then if you make an arrangement of light in such a way that if they fall straight onto the plane of the mirror, this is the plane of the mirror, and then they reflect back, in this case angle of incidence and angle of reflection is zero. I'm showing it again. Now angle of incidence and angle of reflection has some value now. It is going to be zero when incident ray strikes right on the plane of the mirror at right angles. So it goes back in the same direction, right? This is the specialty of the plane mirror. I'm going to introduce two more mirrors here right in front of you. And you can watch closely here. This particular mirror appears little bulged in the front. Look at this. And this is the mirror which is curved inside. They are as if a part of a big spear. If you can imagine a huge spear, and if you can cut one side, then you get that type of mirror here. That's why Since they are part of a sphere, these mirrors are called spherical mirrors. They are not plane on their surfaces. This one is bulged upward, whereas this is what is curved inward. These are not plane mirrors like this. So these mirrors are called spherical mirrors, remember. And how we can draw these spherical mirrors, that we shall see separately. Now, as I have told you that a plane mirror reflects back all the lights here in an opposite direction if the incident rays fall at right angles to each other. Whereas, now I am going to take a concave mirror. This is what is called concave mirror. A mirror which is curved inward is called concave mirror. Right? And if you cut that mirror exactly half, I get this. So that I can place this properly facing this mirror. Even I can insert here. No problem, but it doesn't go here. Right? So some arrangement is made. We have cut this properly here. This is a concave mirror and this is a concave mirror. Remember, I am going to keep a concave mirror, concave, right in front of the three parallel incident rays. Now look at this closely, right? Look at this closely. These rays, particularly this particular rays, hits here and goes in this direction. You see this? Okay, I can bring it here. Look at this. They are coming closer. Right? So I'll bring it here back. And I'm going to put off the light now. And now you can see this. This is the incident ray. While reflection, it bent in this way. This also is bending. So, after reflection, these light rays which are parallel are coming closer and they meet at this particular point, right? So, this is specialty of concave mirror, which is curved downward. I am bringing it here. See, look at this. On reflection, light rays are coming closer and they meet at a particular point. Now I'll take it back and bring this convex mirror. Convex, it is curved upward. And I have a convex mirror with me now here. And look at this. This mirror doesn't bring the light closer. They move away. So remember, convex mirror on reflection moves the light away from it. Right? They come parallel to each other here, but they go away. Whereas concave mirror brings them closer. Look at this. And these light rays meet here. Convex mirror, they do not meet, they go away. So, this type of reflection is called divergence. Remember this. What is this called? Divergence. Convex mirror diverges the light. And concave mirror converges the light. This is called convergence. Right? So, this is convergence. And this is divergence. I am purposely repeating this time and again so that you should be familiar to this. I am going to conclude now. When I keep a plane mirror, light rays moves in the same direction. When I keep the spherical mirror, it doesn't happen. Let me keep this concave mirror, light rays comes closer to each other. And they meet at a particular point. So this phenomena is called converging of light. And which mirror? This is a concave mirror, and this concave mirror, since it is converging the light rays, we can call it as a converging mirror, right? And then I am bringing to a convex mirror. So it diverges the light. Diverges means light goes away, right? So it is a diverging mirror. Convex mirror is diverging mirror. Now, how will you draw these diagrams? That is more important, because when it comes to exam, you should be familiar with the knowledge of drawing. In the next video, we will learn how to draw convergence and divergence of light in concave and convex mirror respectively. See you in the next video. Till then, stay healthy, stay fit. Thank you very much.